My name is Uwe Rascher. I'm working at the Forschungszentrum in Jülich, but I'm also a professor at Bonn University and one of the PIs of the Phenorob. And I would like to give you a short introduction on my research topic. And I'm mainly interested in measuring and understanding plant photosynthesis. And I want to do this, or I do this across scales from the single plant up to the satellite. And how I do this, I will explain you in the next slides. So I think you all know that at the moment, agriculture is going a major digital revolution. We have new sensors, new modes of measurements, which allow us to look into plants, into the structure and the function in plants. And we do not only have new sensors, but we also have new positioning systems. You may all know the rapid development of drones, unmanned aircrafts, which allow us to place our sensors on top of the fields, to fly over fields, and to monitor plants online. But not only this, what we do in Phenorob is also we develop the next generation of robotic systems, ground robots, which intelligently find the plants, can grow over the fields, and which we are currently equipping with our new sensors for plant measurements. And my personal interest actually comes from one main trait of plants, one property, and namely plant photosynthesis. And photosynthesis is the central pathway of plants, which determines really the carbon uptake, which is the basis for all plant growth. And we know that photosynthesis, being the central pathway, is mainly affected by a lot of external threats, by diseases, by droughts, by environmental stresses. And we also know that any limitation in photosynthesis may have impacts on the production of plant material. If photosynthesis is downregulated, then also plant growth is limited, and therefore also the plant products are affected by photosynthesis. And I'm mainly interested in measuring this photosynthetic pathway actually non-invasively in detail. And the measurement trick behind is that we use a signal, namely the so-called fluorescent signal, which is always emitted if the plants absorb light. And you can see it over there. Then as soon as plants, the chlorophylls inside plants absorb light, a red glow may happen, which is actually a side effect of light, which is shuffled through the electron transport chain of photosynthesis. And out of the central course of the photosynthetic machinery, this two-peak feature, a red and faint far red glow, may happen whenever the plant operates and makes photosynthesis. And the nice thing with this fluorescent signal is that it really originates from the reaction center of the photosynthetic machinery. And schematically, if plants absorb light, this energy which is in the light is normally used to drive photosynthesis. However, if the plant receives more light than it actually can use, then these reaction centers may be oversaturated. Not all the energy can be used in photosynthesis, and part of the energy is re-emitted as this fluorescent signal, as this red glow. And the nice thing is, the more limitation or the more energy I have in the reaction center which cannot be used, the higher the fluorescent signal comes. So with this measuring the intensity of the fluorescent signal, we can directly look into the energetic state of the reaction center of the photosynthetic machinery. To be honest, it's not so easy because there are a lot more other processes which the plant can initiate whenever it has an over-energetization of the photosynthetic apparatus. But nevertheless, measuring fluorescence allows us to look directly into the photosynthesis of plants. And this is an approach which we as plant physiologists use a lot since decades. But also recently, the European Space Agency recognized that there's a great potential in measuring this fluorescent signal. And actually, one of the newest satellites, which is currently developed by the European Space Agency, ESA, is a satellite called FLEX, Fluorescence Explorer, which dedicatedly is built at the moment by the European Space Agency to measure vegetation fluorescence on a global scale to get an indicator for photosynthetic activity and also physiological downregulation of plants. And this is exactly where my research comes in. We are interested in this intermittent scale to understand the functioning of plants intermittently up to the satellite. And one of our main focus is to measure, for example, with an airborne sensor, which you can see here. It's a novel development, which we use from an aircraft to measure spectrally highly resolved light, which is emitted and reflected from vegetation. And by using this information and a lot of data processing behind, we can, for example, produce maps like this, where you can see really the actual status of an agricultural region, in this case around our Forschungszentrum in Jülich, and the differences which we can observe by looking in different fields. And that's also what we do together with the Phenodop Consortium. This is an example from Campus Klein-Altendorf, the main experimental site of our Phenodop Consortium, where we have our Phenodop fields on the Campus Klein-Altendorf here next to Bonn. And with research which a postdoc of my group, Bastian Siegmann, did, for example, we try to scale down the information from our airborne sensor down to the small fields of our Phenodop cluster. And by using some downscaling approaches, we could really look down from the aircraft down to the processes which happen in single plots. Here's an example of our Phenodop Central experiment. And this is our main research interest, to get from the physiological understanding from the single plants to the plots up to really larger scale modeling and understanding. And with this, of course, such a research is always a group research, so it's embedded not only in Phenodop but also in a big consortium of international collaborators from Europe and across the scale. And with this, I hope that I could give you an introduction and glimpse of the idea of our research, and I thank you for your attention.